Well, as the opposition decides whether or not to actually boycott this parliament session over the government's insistence on pushing bills through without any scrutiny, we're joined by Derek O'Brien, the chief whip of the Trinamool in the Rajya Sabha. Derek O'Brien, you know, tell us more about why this is happening. I mean, how many bills are we talking about here which have just gone through without any substantive discussion or scrutiny?
Well, thank you for the demotion in Parliament, made me the chief whip, but doesn't matter. Let's give you these numbers. In the 14th Lok Sabha, 60% of bills were scrutinized. In the 15th Lok Sabha, 71% of bills were sent to parliamentary committees for scrutiny. So after 60 and 71%, in the 16th Lok Sabha, the last Lok Sabha, that figure dropped to 26%. So one out of every four bills were being scrutinized. And horror of horrors, in this Lok Sabha, zero. No bills have been sent for any parliamentary scrutiny. And a few minutes ago, we just passed the 14th bill. 14th bill passed in both houses of parliament without parliamentary scrutiny. The quick point I want to make on parliamentary scrutiny. Parliamentary scrutiny does not mean opposition wants to oppose bills always. Some parliamentary scrutiny is done. Engage in public discourse, get people to listen to them, and then make a good bill better or make a bad bill good. That's the reason of parliamentary scrutiny. The BJP hope to run parliament like this. This is completely unacceptable. It's not only the Trinamool Congress, but there are at least 15 opposition parties who are working together to ensure that bills are not passed in this manner.
But Derek, what's the decision on whether or not to boycott this session? Because if you do boycott the session, that means the government pretty much gets a free run to pass these bills that you have a problem with. You still have a thin majority in the Rajya Sabha. So is that a bit of a dilemma for the opposition?
There's an important phrase you've used in your question. You said this session. To my knowledge, this session is today, Wednesday, and two more days, Thursday and Friday. As a member of the Business Advisory Committee in the Rajya Sabha, day after tomorrow is the last day of Parliament. So there's no question of boycotting. Tomorrow is one day and then day after tomorrow.
But there is speculation that Parliament might be extended up to the 9th of August. That's what the reports have said. It may be announced there's in the next couple of days. Then what will you do?
There's also speculation that I've just been chosen as the 17th man to go and play in the Indian cricket team in the West Indies. I cannot comment to you on speculation. I can only comment to you on the rules of Parliament.
But Derek O'Brien, if it happens, if Parliament is extended till the 2nd of August or the 9th of August, as some reports said today, then what will the opposition do? Will you boycott or will you stay and fight it out in the Rajya Sabha?
Firstly, let me tell you, this is not the right way to go about a parliamentary session. Wednesday evening and Business Advisory Committee has not been advised in Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha, and you're talking about extending the session by giving bites on television. No. One. But let me be very clear. We are in Parliament. BJP have won a majority in these Lok Sabha elections. So that's their position as the government. Opposition is not going to cede any space. We are here to fight for parliamentary democracy. We don't want this country to become a presidential form of government. So where is the question of ceding space? We will do our opposition, and opposition in a constructive manner. You bring the RTI bill. We have already told them that we're going to move a resolution. But if this government wants to rewrite the laws of parliament or rewrite the conventions of parliament, we're not here for a teddy bear's picnic. We are here to play the role of a constructive opposition.
All right. Well, Derek O'Brien, let's see how it plays out then in Parliament whether the reports of an extension are indeed correct. Thanks for joining us on NDTV this evening. Thank you.